Say baby.
Baby.
A.
B. Look at that. They're sharp.
Oh, those are some sharp, sharp teeth.
And what?
Lukas was born on September 9th of 2010, and he failed his newborn screening. So after a couple attempts at the hospital, they sent us home thinking that maybe it was just fluid in his ears. So they had us bring him in and had an ABR done a couple of times at Lakeside. And once he wasn't responding to those, then they suggested for us to go to Boys Town. It was a big shock for us. We have no hearing loss in our family or our immediate family. So it came as a big surprise to try to figure out how are we gonna deal with this.
The first thing for me was I thought 20 years ahead, he's gonna have a hard time getting a job if he can't hear. Then I set my expectations very low. I set them basically to the point where as long as he can hear like environment sounds, ambulances, an alarm clock, those kind of things, I'll be okay with that. We'll just use sign language.
We felt so much better after talking to the audiologist, a parent infant specialist, just basically the staff at Boys Town.
We met one staff member who's a mom for several deaf kids, and it was very comforting to know that her son was successful, he was going to college, you know, he's made it that far. That was when I started to relax a little bit.
We wanted to give him the option of hearing, so that way he has that option in the future. If he chose to be deaf and to sign, he had that option as well. So we wanted to give him all of his opportunities.
I was very concerned about him not having a hearing nerve. His scores on the ABR test was really at the bottom. But once we had the MRI and we found out that he had the nerve and he can go ahead with surgery, yes, that was a relief. Once everything was on track, it was almost on autopilot. We were almost guided through the process. We met the implant team. It basically took a lot of the stress away. You have a whole team basically backing you up.
He had his, you know, first holiday of Christmas and coming into 2012, which is, you know, a lot of audiologist visits, going about, I think, every week for a period of time, then switching to every other week. But it was definitely necessary just to make sure that things were going the way they were supposed to.
The first thing we did was that he responded to was me knocking on the walls. He would turn around when I knocked on the walls. So I did a lot of knocking on the walls.
High five. Yeah!
It felt great to know that he's responding to sound. It definitely gave you the energy to, you know, to keep going, basically.
C.
No! Yeah. I
thought he would never leave.
He's doing excellent. He's leading, he's following, he's playing with other kids, they're chasing each other, so just like any other four-year-old. It's just amazing how far he's come.
Where are they walking?
They're walking to that little house.
That little house?
He loves his books. We can't probably buy enough books or any new books that we get. We have to read them over and over and over again.
It has to be a thrilling story, so I really have to work at that. If I go to the library or buy a book, it can't be something boring. It has to be something weird or scary in there, and then it'll keep his attention.
Happy birthday, dear daddy. Happy birthday to you.
Sometimes it's even hard to remember that he's even deaf. That tests that they have done at Boys Town with regards to his hearing has been on par with actual hearing kids. So that's a relief, and that's considering he has artificial hearing, I think that's crazy.
I would tell other families how great Boys Town is, from the support that they've given us, the shoulder to lean on, the endless questions that I have asked in the beginning and that I still ask. With all of their assistance, we're more than happy with his result.
I remember telling my parents who live overseas that we're lucky we live in Omaha, of all places, when it comes to this, because you have a terrific center that specializes in this.
He will probably be set up for next year to go on to kindergarten and mainstream school. We want to make sure that he stays on track. And with all the support that we have, we know that he's going to be doing just fine.